Amy Walter Cook's political report, that's the difficulty here. They have multiple non-Trump candidates to choose from. I think this race from the very beginning has been reduced to these three main groups of about 30.35% Republican voters who will stay with Trump no matter what. These people are going nowhere. The 20% who will never vote for Trump. A fraction of them, and then whatever is left here. Somewhere around 50% sit and say they love Trump. And right now they're probably telling pollsters that they voted for Trump. But they're open to other options. Me, what I saw last night was good news for Donald Trump. First, Ron DeSantis did a good enough job. I think you're right. H is still in the mix, but overshadowed by Ramaswamy. And remember, Ramaswamy is candidate closest to Donald Trump. The candidate who will constantly defend Donald Trump and split votes with him. The other issue, as Lisa points out in her post, is when asked if they would support Donald Trump if he was found guilty. Except for two. Everyone raised their hands. If you're trying to convince voters who are ambivalent or looking around about Donald Trump and conviction isn't enough to get those people say, I won't support him. Why would I, as a voter, think about it? And then, as we said, in the end, I think we got out of this with three candidates. Ramaswamy, Haley, and DeSantis, who performed reasonably well or received good attention. But none of them were able to pull that together. Never Trump. And sometimes the Trump coalition. So second line question is, I guess we'll see if DeSantis is still out there when the polls come out. But that's really question of how much they have make up to get close Donald Trump.